Welcome back to another Epic Future Space. My name is Mike, and NASA has a lot of freaking acronyms. So I recently made a video talking about the COTS program and the commercial cargo capability that will be going on with that. But today I wanted to talk about the Commercial Crew Program, or CCDEV program, which stands for Commercial Crew Development. And both the CCDEV and COTS programs are being run by the Commercial Crew and Cargo Program Office, or C-3PO. The program was initially started in 2006, and after the first initial rounds of the COTS program, they started going into the CCDEV program. The first round was started in 2010, and there were five winners of that program. The first was United Launch Alliance, working on the human rating of their Atlas V rocket, which is what several other companies have chosen as their rocket of choice. And then was Sierra Nevada Corporation, working on their Dream Chaser space plane. Paragon Space Development, which worked on a life support system, and the final was Boeing. And Boeing received their contract towards their CST-100 space capsule. Also, Blue Origin won a contract in order to further develop their space capsule as well. Now, the first round, there was quite a few milestones that they were able to achieve, but they quickly moved on to the CCDEV-2 program. And with the CCDEV-2 program, there was only four companies that they initially selected, one of which was SpaceX, furthering their Dragon capsule to make it human-rated, mostly working on the launch abort system so that it can escape if anything ever happens. And then Boeing won a contract to further development for their CST-100 capsule. Sierra Nevada Corporation won more money to work on their Dream Chaser space plane. And then finally, Blue Origin won the final contract towards furthering their development. Now, there have been a couple of companies since then that have gotten Space Act agreements. They haven't actually gotten any funding from NASA, but they have been able to get the research and technical data that NASA has been able to accumulate over the past 50 years towards furthering their program and making sure that they're able to do things safely. One of those is ATK and their partnership with Eads Astrum, creating the Liberty rocket, which is pretty much a remix of the Ares 1 rocket. And then Excalibur Almes has also won a Space Act agreement. And of course, United Launch Alliance also got a more technical data in order to further the human development on their Atlas V rocket. Now, I'm going to be making another video very soon talking about each company in particular and the hardware that they're working with, and give you a little bit more on what sort of updates they are working on. And also, let me know in the comments below what you think about this video, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and be sure to thumbs up this video. And if you haven't already, be sure to check out some of these links right here to my band page and also some friends of mine that I'm appearing in their Futurecast Now show. And this video has been recorded and edited, produced by Alex Feldman, who makes really great shorts, which you can check out his channel right here. I did a few things for him in the past, which unfortunately are no longer up on YouTube, but maybe I can convince him to re-upload that so you guys can check it out. But anyway, we're going to be doing some stuff together, so be sure to subscribe to his channel and see more of my pretty face on there. Yeah, I know, whatever. But I will see you guys next time, and we'll talk about more space stuff. We'll see you guys later.